Hello friends, welcome to Learn and Explore. Today in this video I will show you how to extract coordinates from Google Earth Pro. On YouTube I have shown different videos, but no one has told how to extract the coordinates exactly. So I will show you the right way, right method. So in the Google Earth Pro, what you have to do is you have to add a path, okay, or points. I am adding a path and I will make a polygon in this Google Earth Pro software. And I will export this polygon to lat long format, polylong coordinates, each vertices. Okay, so now I'm adding the vertices of the polygon. I'm taking a plot, for example, you can see. So first I'm going to add path and just created the polygon. And now, okay, so like this way you have to add a polygon. And in the left side of the software, under the places option, you can rename this as whatever your area is. So myself is WBASI area. Now what you have to do is you have to save this as SavePlaceAs. There is two option in the Google Earth, save as option. Save as type should be KML, not KMZ, because KML is a readable format. Okay, so keep in mind that you have to save this data, save this place as KML format. Now I'm opening the directory where I have saved that KML file and see this file and open this file with the Notepad so that we can read the text whatever in within this file. So here you can see that the coordinates and the everything, the attributes are also shown here. So now what I'll do is select all the text. Okay, select all the text and copy it and open Excel in your computer. So in the Excel I will paste the overall text what I have copied before. Now see, you can find the coordinates here. It is in the only single row wise. So this is the coordinates. So I will copy only the coordinates, but rest of the I will leave. And I'm going to the second sheet and paste the coordinates only. So here I got the coordinate. Now I will divide the coordinate into different columns. So you have to go to the data menu, then you will find text to column options. In the text to column option, choose delimited, then next, and only check mark on the comma option. Keep the other blank and now finish. So all the lat and long is separated in different columns. Now what I'll do, the copy the whole row, go to the next sheet and paste as transpose. That is, in the transpose what it do, you can see that all the columns, separate columns, are converted into rows. Okay, now see, in my longitude value there is zero space is not required for me, so I will remove this zero space. So I'm going to replace option. You can find it in the home tab and find what zero space, and in the replace with thing blank. So replace all. Okay, you can see that latitude and longitude is converted, okay, in the right format. I'm deleting this zero, I don't require this, and wait for the last step. That is, I am arranging this data, longitude and latitude, in point wise format, okay, by filtering the data. And you keep watching this video, I will convert this lat long also to the UTM option also, UTM coordinate system. So now I will filter this data, value type, okay. So you can filter this data like this. So I'm first selecting the latitudes. I'm selecting only latitudes and copying this latitude to, I'm opening another sheet. Okay, I'm pasting this data here. Just latitude comes, and now I will select only longitude and I will select this longitude value and paste it like this. So I have successfully converted the KML file to lat long. Okay, it is very easy to is. Now we will convert this data to UTM. So copy this data, go to the Notepad, and paste it. Now what you have to do is you have to save this data as CSV format. CSV is comma separated value. Okay, so I have saved this data as CSV format, and now I will open QGIS. What is QGIS? QGIS is an open source data GIS software that is free to use, and this is not a paid software. This is totally free to use, and you can download it from download.qgis.org, and like your you can download it. So when you open the QGIS, here you will find that add delimited WCS layer. Okay, in the add delimited WCS layer, you have to import that point what you have exported, that like CSV. Okay, so in the X field you have to put longitude, and Y field you have to put latitude. Okay, and the WGS 84 reference data will be there because lat long data is WGS 84. Okay, so I have imported this data like this, and I will check whether my data is correct or not. So I'm going to Google Earth view in that within the software. The left side of the place you will find the Google Earth view option. So I'm checking that points whether it is imported or not. See, right, whatever I exported from the Google Earth Pro, it is the lat long is right. So now I will save this place as comma separated value, and I will choose the output directory for converting the lat long data to UTM. Okay, so I'm going to, my name is exported to UTM, and the CRS system, that is coordinate reference system, is WGS84. But in my condition, the longitude is 88 degree. So if 88 degree, so I have already made a video about this, how to calculate the UTM zone. So you can find this after the ending of this video. So for my example, the UTM zone is 45 north. I'm searching for UTM zone 45, and I will select 45 north. Okay, now okay, so it will show you that saving done and exporting is complete. Now open the output directory what you have provided. So here you will find that exported UTM. So read only, you can see that X and Y here. The X is denotes easting and Y denotes the northing value. Okay, hope you like this video guys, and don't forget to subscribe our channel, and I will see you in another video. Thank you, and I will give that all the file in the comment box. Download this file for your practice. Okay, so thank you so much for watching.